Hey, Chris Waters here, taking a look at the new Moondance trailer for Borderlands, the pre-sequel. In addition to the wub-wubs and poop jokes, there's actually some interesting information about the game in there, so let's dig in and see what it tells us. Kicks right off with a character parade, starting with Claptrap the Frag Trap, a character you can actually play as this time around. And then, next up is Handsome Jack. Notice the distinct lack of freaky stretched-out face parts. He's younger. And maybe less evil? Probably not. Then we've got Wilhelm the Enforcer, who has a robo-eye, amongst other robo-parts. The third bald hunter, Nisha, the Lawbringer, who shops at Hot Topic and looks like she can dual-wield weapons. The fourth and final bald hunter, Athena, the Gladiator, who really doesn't like to be compared to Captain America, even though, come on, with the shield thing, it's just right there. And yes, Claptrap can actually hold guns. Oh hey, Mad Moxie, looking quite mechanical here. I mean, I guess it makes sense. Her kids, Scooter and Ellie, are both car geniuses. They must have gotten the knowledge from somewhere. Claptrap mustache. Oh hey, Lilith, the Siren, probably not the only character from the first Borderlands we're gonna see. And for all you made-up word aficionados, let's just break this down. Bazillion Diester. Bazillion Dorst. And Godzillion Deer? Oh for three. That kicks off a combat montage starring these little dudes who are either midgets in spacesuits or little moon men straight out of Area 51. Quick glimpse of the ice elemental damage breaking dudes apart. Wait, is that a brain? Paging Dr. Ned! Couple variations on the new weapon type, lasers. And a question, where does this ice meteor come from? Oh, all right, it's just a grenade, probably the ice damage, but it looked like it was a meteor, okay? Oh, sweet Argyle fashion disaster, is Bert gonna love this one? Actually, before that text pops in, you get to see a few tidbits about this gun that are interesting. You got your elemental damage, your melee damage bonus, your Starship Troopers joke, would you like to know more? And an interesting little attribute called Moonshine that confers a +5% chance of enemies dropping rare loot. Now this looks like a relatively high level gun, but it makes you wonder if we won't be seeing more diverse bonuses tacked onto weapons in an effort to make the whole operation more bazillion-donical, whatever. Got one of those little Roswell alien dudes riding a fiery moon skag like He-Man and Battlecat over here. And something you can ride, this flying new motorcycle thingy called the Stingray. Pair of moon Gorons, moon dinosaur, Moon Man, not really a monster, kind of anticlimactic here. Okay, now let's spend a little time here. There's a bunch of skills on display for Athena. The kinetic aspis at the top, that's her shield that can absorb frontal damage and then be thrown at enemies to deliver twice the absorbed damage. It also looks like you can boost a couple of the aspis attributes, like cooldown, active duration, and defensive arc, which determines the area of damage absorption. There's a bunch of predictable buffs to health and damage, etc., many of which are fueled by the aspis, but there's a few interesting ones, like Crucis, which makes melee attacks knock back enemies with explosive force, Prismatic Aegis, which absorbs and dishes out elemental damage, Clear! Just by throwing the aspis, you give any downed allies in range a second wind, and you yourself get more damage in Fight for Your Life mode once you've activated this thingy-o. Stalwart allows your friends to blast the shield to charge it up with damage so you can throw it back and do extra damage. And Prepare for Glory, the aspis throw acts as a taunt and baits your enemies to attack you. When they do, you get a stack of Prepare for Glory, whatever that is. It's something that increases your weapon damage while it lasts, and it slowly fades away after the aspis comes back home to mama. You also get a look at Wilhelm, the Enforcer's skill tree. His active skill is to summon two automated drones called Wolf and Saint. Most of these are concerned with Wolf and Saint efficiency and duration, etc. The interesting ones are the cybernetic augmentations, like Power Fist, which changes the melee to an explosive punch with extended range, and Shock Absorbers, which allows you to shoot while sprinting and gain bonus damage and have no accuracy penalties. The cool thing is you can actually see the character model change once these skills are unlocked. Boom! Robo Arm! All this brings Wilhelm closer to his eventual I am a robot now state that we encounter him in Borderlands 2. No word though on how those robot upgrades affect his dancing skills. Hey, look, Chewbacca moon buggy, and what appears to be a drugstore called Darksiders. Yes, that's with an H, not a K, so we're probably gonna have to go on a quest titled Special K for whoever the Walter Whiteian proprietor of that establishment is, right? Little Michael Bay circle strafe pan around Nisha using a handgun the size of her arm and also twirling a gun in her other hand, dual wielding, yes. Few shots of Athena looking totally bad, eh? Claptrap manning the turret on this buggy like a little foul-mouthed R2 unit. I'd say they'd gone off the deep end with these phrases, but with jovial fear pooping, I think they've gone beyond the deep end to whatever's beyond the deep end. This flying thingy has some pretty nasty tooth work painted around the cockpit. Nice touch there, boss man. It's probably a boss. There's something quietly majestic about Claptrap tracing a gentle arc through the sky, but here's the weird thing with this shot. Look what happens when his bullets hit the target. It's love. What do you think? Like converting enemies to fight for you, maybe? Probably. That does not look like a dance kitten. October 14th release date, all right, that's cool. It's not like there's not a billion other games coming out in October. Are you trying to kill us? Chucking the Aspis at Claptrap for some reason. Jogging by a gross moon blob tentacle alien thingy. And the obligatory finger gun to the head finisher. Rightio, yep, Borderlands, the pre-sequel, coming to PC, Xbox 360, and PlayStation 3 on October 14th. Be sure to let us know anything you spotted in the trailer in the comments below, and come on back to GameSpot at noon on Tuesday, the first day of E3, for a live demo of Borderlands the pre-sequel. I'll see you there.
Stop. Candles in like that. What are you going for? That helped me.